Money Monday edition of Liquid Lunch indeed. And so money that we brought back the M Squared, the money man himself, Frank Morano, joins me again. And I really missed you, pal.
First and foremost,
I did miss you. I tried not to call you, but I know.
I was in a foreign country, and I paid $10 a day for internet access so that I could watch occasional snippets of Liquid Lunch.
All right. Well, we were going through
some growing pains
last week, yeah. but we still are, that's part of amazing, organic, unique content that we're giving America, and we're growing every day. I'm going to talk to you off air, but the viewers are growing, and we're keeping audience. We're doing all the these statistical things that the networks look for. But there was a big outcry last week. I had a Morano separation anxiety, not having you around for so long. It was hard.
Well, that's nice. Well, that was the slogan of a Congressman Morano back in the day, bring Morano back. And if you go to my Instagram, Instagram.com/MoranoVision, you can see that button, bring Morano back. It's on there. I think that's actually my profile. A button that says bring Morano back. But
so I was allowed to run free.
Yeah,
while you were gone, I'm a free range journalist. And I don't know why the shot's still on you when I'm talking, but I guess Abdul is not.
A lot of people were.
There he is.
You were right before.
Free range journalist last week while you were gone. There was no one here to keep me in line. There were no gates, no cages.
That's right.
And I could say as many exaggerations as I want, and no one corrected me.
Yeah,
I haven't been WTF'd in a while.
If we didn't get canceled after last week, chances are pretty good we're going to be here a while.
Yeah, don't jinx it.
But I do want to, on a serious note, the president made the decision yesterday to essentially pull our troops out of Syria. He's been tweeting about it all day,
great,
as have been his Republican so-called allies, Lindsey Graham, Marco Rubio, even his own former appointees, the former governor of South Carolina, who he appointed to the UN. It's very interesting, every single time that Donald Trump departs from the bipartisan foreign policy orthodoxy, which, by the way, is what we voted for,
yep,
and in part the reason that he got elected, isn't it amazing how the mainstream media, the think tanks, Republicans and Democrats, including his own former appointees,
yep,
they all jump on him to,
yep,
tell how wrong he is. Why is it that whenever American troops are withdrawing from some place, we're always warned there's going to be a genocide. We're always,
yep,
warned it's dangerous.
Yep. Yep.
We're always warned it's irresponsible. Why are we never warned that it's irresponsible to keep American troops in a foreign country that doesn't want them?
Yeah,
for
how about that?
Let's try one of those. It's days like this that I'm thrilled that Donald Trump doesn't listen to his critics. And I thought it was very telling that Mayor Ghazali was supportive of this plan to eventually let the Kurds fight their own battles.
It's crazy. Maybe you should think about it. When the Democrats and Republicans never agree on anything, Barack Obama ran and said he's going to bring our troops home. He didn't.
Nikki Haley.
Sent in even more troops into Afghanistan. Trump ran and said, I'm going to close the borders, I'm going to create jobs, and I'm going to bring our troops home. And I'm going to put the Israeli embassy in Jerusalem.
Shocking.
So he keeps doing things he told us, which is amazing because that never happens. And now he wants to bring our fighting troops out of harm's way, bring them back to America. And Republicans and Democrats are mad. So that should tell you something. And if you remember, going back to 2015, 16, Donald Trump not only beat Hillary Clinton, he beat every single contender from the Republican Party. So he's no stranger to beating his own party and breaking their back and getting them behind him and beating the Democrats. So
the one prominent Republican on the national scene that I did see give him credit in the last couple of hours was Senator Rand Paul of Kentucky.
Right.
So Rand Paul, again, being very intellectually honest on that one. So
and Trump wasn't even nice to Rand Paul.
Right.
It's not even
exactly
like Rand is like a fan fave with,
yeah,
the president or anything. But, he calls spade a spade, I guess, and he sees some good action. That's what the president told us he would do. And he did it. And the other day, lowest unemployment in history, lowest African-American unemployment in American history. GDP growth still just around 3%. Every great thing that could happen for the economy, lower taxes, is happening. And the Dems, they just want to continue to focus in on the negatives. We'll be focusing on the positives right here tomorrow on Liquid Lunch, noon to 2 Eastern. Same bat time, same bat channel.
Are we sure? Thanks. All right.